Hello. So, another reading from Jean Key's Empowerment, book, the Glossary of Empowerment. Sanskaras. Sanskaras are bioenergetic memories that are passed down all ancestral lines. Your sanskaras are the wound opportunities that you have inherited during your lifetime. Such memories are more than simple memories held in the mind, but are charges of kinetic energy that give rise to your behavioural patterns, beliefs, and general outlook. So in the Jean Keys, when we talk about doing shadow work and going into transforming your shadows, we're really talking about this. We're talking about dealing with sanskaras. This is a Sanskrit word taken from the ancient Vedic teachings. And there are these memory slates that literally lie overlapped, kind of impressed into our energy bodies and embedded in our DNA, because we've inherited all kinds of ancestral energies and memories through our ancestral lines, our bloodlines. And we don't know half of what happened in our ancestral lines, but we carry it nonetheless. We carry the good and the bad. And so these sanskaras are literally the workings of our karma, the charges of kinetic energy. That means that they are dynamic. They kind of govern our life, our worldview, and our behavioral patterns, our beliefs, are all because of our sanskaras. Sanskaras are not in any way personal, nor are they the result of actions in past lives. Now, here's an example of where I've made a mistake in the Jean Keys. I would put an always in there. Sanskaras are not in any way personal, nor are they always the result of actions in past lives. Well, the best of us make mistakes. The point is that what comes before governs what comes after. That's the basis of karma. So karma is both personal, and yet at another level it isn't personal. It's personal to the vehicle. It's personal to the essence, the soul, the what I call the causal body, the part of us that continues to incarnate in the illusion of time and space. This part of us, that this essence that contains the storyline of our awakening, of our evolution, of our spiritual evolution over, you know, these are the memories that we carry over different lifetimes. So yes, what we do is imprinted in that essence, and that essence then gathers to itself the environmental factors that it needs to evolve to the next level. And so there is a continuity, but also where the term here talks about they're not in any way personal, that's also true, even though that is it's both personal and not personal. It's not personal, because the further you go back in your bloodlines, the more merged you become with the field of all humanity, and indeed even with the animal kingdoms and the mineral kingdoms, the further you go back. And so, you know, there's this part of us that is playing the game, the drama, and in that sense it isn't personal. You can't take it personally, because you have the exact ingredients you need, the exact sanskaras you need, the exact issues that you need in this lifetime in order to make the next leap in initiation in your evolution and your spiritual evolution. So rather, your sanskaras determine the specific themes of the great challenges you will face during your life. Once you realize that such patterns are not caused consciously by you, but are your greatest opportunities for transformation and evolution, the challenges in your life become much easier to bear. That's when you stop seeing it personally and you just go, well, this is exactly what I need, but I just, you know, for my next leap in evolution, these circumstances in this life you know, they fit exactly, and there is, I am given that which I can bear, that which I can transform, and the wider, you know, the radiance of your light, then the more you can bear, the more you can transform. The Venus sequence provides a systematic means of tracking and transforming the specific sanskaras that you carry during your lifetime. So it's interesting it mentions the Venus sequence there. And those of you who don't know the Venus sequence, that is one of the sequences of the Golden Path. And what it does is it allows you to precisely track the sanskaras, the patterns, these slates, these memory slates, karmic slates in your lifetime. So you can see the exact map of the unfolding of your wound opportunities in this life, and therefore your greatest potential, because you can see the cities. So when you consider your sanskaras, when you're contemplating this, think about the wound opportunities that you have in this life, and think about them as, you know, they can take you into those city realms, you know, those highest realms. And they can lead to these gifts, these creative gifts. And that's what they're here for. And the Venus sequence will help you with that in a very gentle, nurturing, tender way, particularly if you do it with others, along with others. I highly recommend that. And it's a very deep contemplation, the sanskaras. Think about them and where they came from inside you. And you don't need to worry about like why you have them. You just need to know that they are perfect for your next initiation. That's what they do. They are the storyline that provides you the fabric, the rungs of the ladder for you to take the next leap in your spiritual evolution.